Welcome to Unite Coaching. In this tutorial, we are going to learn the analysis and design of a one-way slab, which is simply supported. The slab is of 2 meter by 6 meter. It is supported by 230 millimeter beams. Grade of concrete is assumed as 20 newton per millimeter square and the steel is of 415 grade. The clear cover is assumed as 20 millimeters. So, to design the slab in Microsoft Excel, make a table like this. Dimension of room, thickness of support, grade of concrete and steel and clear cover. The first step is to calculate design factors. The first factor is neutral axis factor, whose formula is 700 divided by 1100. Plus 0.87 into grade of steel Fy, so the formula in Excel will be equals to 700 divided by bracket 1100 plus 0.87 into cell H12. The next factor is moment resisting factor, whose formula is 0.36 into grade of concrete Fck into Ku max bracket 1 minus 0.42 into Ku max. So, the formula in Excel will be equals to 0.36 into cell H11 into cell H15 into bracket 1 minus 0.42 into cell H15. The last factor is steel factor, whose formula is 0.36 into grade of concrete into Ku max divide by 0.87 into grade of steel Fy, so the formula in Excel will be equal to 0.36 into cell H11 into cell H15 divide by bracket 0.87 into cell H12. Next step is to calculate the effective lengths. The formula is the length plus the thickness of support. So, the formula in Excel will be equal to cell H8 plus cell H10. Similarly, in other direction, it will be equal to cell H7 plus cell H9. There is a check for the slab to check whether the slab is two-way or one-way. If the ratio of Ly by Lx is greater than or equal to 2, then the slab designed as one-way. And if is less than 2, it is designed as two-way slab. Let's check if it is to be designed as one-way or two-way slab. Formula in Excel will be equals to cell H20 divided by cell H19 greater than symbol equals to symbol and at last 2. The next step is to calculate depth of slab. As our slab is one-way simply supported, I will use formula as length of shorter side, divide by 20 into 1.2. This formula is taken from Indian Standard Code 4562000. For that, the formula in Excel will be equals to cell H19 divided by 20 into 1.2 and at last, multiply by 1000. This 1000 is taken because depth of slab required is in millimeters. It comes to be 92 millimeters, so assuming more than that for safe design. So I am assuming effective depth of slab as 100 millimeters. Therefore, total depth of slab will be effective depth plus clear cover plus half of diameter of bar. So, the formula in Excel will be equals to cell H27. Plus cell H13, plus 5. This 5 is taken because I am assuming the diameter of bar as 10 millimeters. The next step is to calculate the total load on slab. First, calculate the self-weight of slab, whose formula is depth of slab into density of concrete, which is taken as 25 kilonewton per meter cube. So the formula in Excel will be equal to cell H28 into 25 divided by 1000. I am assuming weight of flow finish as 1 kN per meter square. And live load on slab is assumed as 2 kN per meter square. So, calculate the total load on slab. Formula in Excel will be equal to cell H30 plus cell H31 plus cell H32, which comes to be 6.13 kN per meter square. Make this characteristic load as ultimate load by multiplying it by a factor of safety of 1.5. Therefore, the formula in Excel will be equals to cell H36 into 1.5. The next step is to calculate effective length for slab. The formula for it is center to center distance between the supports or the clear span plus effective depth for simply supported slab. Minimum of above two values is taken as effective length. So the formula in Excel will be equals to cell H19, since it is already calculated in the above steps. Next formula will be equal to cell H8 plus cell H27 divided by 1000. The effective length is taken as minimum of above two values. So, the formula in Excel will be equals to MIN bracket cell I40 comma cell I41. Next step is to calculate factored bending moment on slab. As our slab is simply supported, the formula will be factored load into square of effective span divided by 8. So, the formula in Excel will be equals to cell H38 into cell F42 square divided by 8. The next step is to calculate required depth of slab, whose formula is square root of maximum factored bending moment divided by IU max into 1000. So, the formula in Excel will be equals to SQRT bracket cell H44 into 10 to the power 6 divided by bracket cell H16 into 1000. This 10 to the power is taken because the moment should be taken in Newton millimeters. The next thing to do is check the depth of slab, that whether the depth of slab is safe or not. For that, required depth should be less than assumed depth. So, the formula in Excel will be equals to cell H47 less than cell H27. It is showing true, means our assumption is correct and safe. So, enter the value of depth of slab which you want to provide. I will provide it as 100 millimeters. So, the overall depth will be 125 millimeters, as calculated earlier. The last part in our design is to calculate the area of steel required in both the directions of slab. The formula for calculation of area of steel shown here. Putting same formula in Excel, it will be equal to bracket 1 minus SQRT bracket 1 minus bracket 4.6 into cell H44 into 10 to the power 6 divided by bracket cell H11 into 1000 into cell H49 square 4 times bracket into 0.5 into cell H11 into 1000 into cell H49 divided by cell H12. I will be using 8 mm diameter bars. You can use any standard size bars as per requirement. The formula for spacing is 1000 into pi by 4 into diameter square divided by area of steel required. So, the formula in Excel will be equal to 1000 into 3.1415, which is the value of pi, into cell H53 raised to 2 divided by 4 into cell H52, which comes as 347.39 millimeters, which is greater than minimum spacing given by the Indian code. Therefore, for SUFA design, I will use spacing of main reinforcement as 270 millimeters. From that, Calculate the area of steel provided. The formula will be same as of spacing of bars. The only difference is that, at last it will be divided by the spacing provided. There is a check for area of steel as per Indian code, that, it should not be less than 0.12% of gross sectional area if you are using tow steel, and it should not be less than 0.15% of gross sectional area if you are using mild steel bar. I have used tow steel bars. Therefore, I will use 0.12%. So, the formula in Excel will be equal to bracket 0.12% into 1000 into cell H50. The last part in our design is calculation of distribution steel. The formula for calculation of distribution steel is same as the formula of minimum area of steel. So put the same formula in Excel for this calculation. The rest of the part will be same as calculated earlier in main reinforcement calculations. At the last, prepare a table of your design summary like this. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe for more civil engineering tutorial videos. If you have any questions regarding this video, please feel free to ask and comment your doubts in the comments section below. Thank you.